How's it going, everybody? The head coaching search for the University of Hawaii men's basketball team has come to an end, as sources confirm that Eran Ganot will become the 21st head coach in program history. Associate head coach at St. Mary's, 33-year-old, went 3-2 in 5 games as the acting head coach of the Gaels in 2014, filling in for a suspended Randy Bennett. Now, New Jersey native spent 4 years as an assistant at UH under Riley Wallace and Bob Nash before landing a gig with St. Mary's in 2011. In that time, Gaels went an impressive 80-22. An official announcement from UH is scheduled for tomorrow morning. Today, former all-conference standout Bill Amos, who played under Ganot, expressed a positive reaction.
Well, I'm really excited for the news of Coach Ganot getting the head coaching job at UH. He used to always say that this was his dream job. It was always obvious to all of us players that he was going to be a really successful basketball coach. He's one of the few coaches I've ever had who has a great mix of basketball IQ, work ethic, and the psychology of a great coach. And I think this is going to be a perfect opportunity for him. I'm sure he's already, he already can't wait to get to work recruiting and building his team.
Now, of course, Ganot's selection marks as the end of the Benjy Taylor era at UH. Interim head coach who took over for a fired Gibb Arnold just 6 days before the team's first exhibition game went 22-13, leading the Bows to the Big West Conference championship game. Today, an emotional Taylor told me that he is beyond disappointed.
You know, it's a sad day for me, but when something happens like this, you have to move on and hold your head high and, you know, continue to show character. That's what we did this year. I wish Eran, the best of luck.
When you look at the job that you did this year, do you think you could have done anything more than what you did to try and prove that you could be the head men's basketball coach at the University of Hawaii?
No, there was nothing else I could have done. You know, I think if we would have been playing this weekend in Indy, I still think this was going to happen. And I felt like that throughout the course of the year wasn't supported very much. But that being said, a lot of people ask me, well, if you felt that way, how could you still go out and win 22 games? And it was my job. I wish him the best. I wish the university the best. I'm blessed. And I'm better now than I was 5 months ago. Yeah. Yeah. Hey, I just want to say thank you to everybody. I love you guys, and thanks.
Now, Taylor, who is currently in the Midwest, says he will begin writing the next chapter in his career and is confident he will be able to continue coaching at the collegiate level. And speaking of moving forward, major question marks remain regarding the status of current Rainbow Warriors with the program. Today, freshman guard Isaac Fleming sent a cryptic message saying in consecutive tweets, I have to do what's best for me at the end of the day, and it was a fun year. I will always love Hawaii. Fleming, who averaged 10 points and 2 assists per game, did not return messages left by KHON. We'll keep you posted as this story develops.